Hi YouTube, just finished making a top quilt, so I thought I'd show you it. I tried to put as many features in it as I could without sacrificing on performance and weight and make it as versatile as I can, the highest performance. So we'll have a look and see what you think. So in terms of materials, I'm not going to do a tutorial on how I made it at the moment. It's just too complicated. But the fabric, the main fabric is this stuff, very light. It's a 20 denier taffeta, nylon taffeta, and it's calendared on one side. It's got a DWR impregnation into the fibres, so it's not a coating, so it won't rub off. And on the other side, it's uncoated and uncalendered, so it's all matte. It's not glossy. It's nice and smooth, and it feels good against the skin. And it's pretty strong stuff. So you can go 10 denier and you can go 7 denier, which are ultra light, but then you have to be real careful about ripping and punctures and all that kind of stuff. So I decided to go for a 20D because I want to last a little while. I don't want to make another one for a while. Yeah, this is ideal. It's only 36 grams per square meter, which is super light. This is great stuff. So I've got some of this. This is from Extreme Textile in Germany, imported from Germany. The dang, probably the most important part. I decided to go to dang this time instead of synthetic because I'm fine with the synthetic, good for summer, but if you want real deep winter stuff, then I don't think the synthetic cuts it really. You need so much of it to get down to really low temperatures that the bulks and weight's just not worth it. So I've gone for dang on this one. So this is gonna be ultra light, ultra small packing. This is the dang that I used. Get a close up. To focus. There you go, that's the down that I used. Super light. This is the highest spec down. This is 950 fill power. It's not easy to get, it's really hard to get, especially in Europe. You can buy an 850 down, which is really good from Extreme Textile, and I've used that in the past, it's excellent. But I wanted to go a step higher, so I had to work with a manufacturer of another industry, not camping, in Poland, who uses this stuff by the ton. And they've got some extremely high quality products for special customers, where they use a 950 down, ethically sourced. And they, after working with them for a long time and discussing with them a lot, they've agreed to sell me some of their down that they use. So I've got a source now for a good, well, super, the best quality down at a reasonable price. It's still expensive because 950 down is not cheap wherever you go, but at least it's reasonable and a lot cheaper than buying a quilt in the shop. So that's good. Baffles, it's a baffle design. I use this stuff. This stuff is also very light. It's a mosquito meshing that I got from America, from Dutchware Gear. It's pre-cut into the width that you need. That's why I bought it. It just saves loads of time. So this is a 3-inch width baffle, and I used a 2.5-inch width height on my baffle in the final finish. So I folded over the ends and stitched, so it's got like a double layer at one end, and then I folded over the other end and stitched, so you end up with 2.5 inches with a double fold at each end, so nice and strong, perfect for that kind of stuff. So I was thinking about using Cuban fibre. I've got some very lightweight Cuban fibre, but the weight difference wasn't that great compared to the netting, and I was thinking that because the Cuban fibre is solid, it wouldn't let air flow through it. It might also encourage condensation inside of the quilt, and also it rustles. So I didn't want to have a quilt that every time I move, I could hear the Cuban fibre rustling. So I decided against Cuban fibre, even though I could have used it. I think the mesh is a lot better. Plus, because it's a mesh, the down catches on the mesh and it provides a bit more resistance in the quilt. to stop the dye moving around, which is also what I wanted. So, let's have a look at the quilt. So this is the quilt. Just a tip, if you've got any down products, sleeping bags or quilts or underquilts, never store them in a stuff sack compressed. It really does damage the down over time. Always have a nice big airy bag. You see how light it is. This is made from a very quite a thick high quality Egyptian cotton, but any cotton, any bed sheet, just sew it up into a big bag to store you down. Keeps the dust off, keeps it lofted and aired so no fungus or anything can grow in there. It's the best way to keep all your gear. So the quilt itself in total is 700 grams, which is very light. It will take me down to minus 6. That's the rating I calculated. But after looking at it, and it's much, much higher loft than my Rab Ascent sleeping bag, which I've had down to minus 7. So I think I can go to minus 7, maybe even minus 10 with a vapor quilt on top. No problem at all. So this is my deep winter bag, but I'll probably use it in the summer because it's easy to vent and easy to use. So you can see how lofty it is. It's just poofy. There's black on one side, orange on the other. Not just for aesthetics, but for a couple of reasons. Black is the quickest to dry out in the sun in the morning. So I normally have it with the orange on the inside and black on the outside. Then if any condensation ends up on here or dew, then that will dry out real fast, even though it's got DWR coating. But if I've got a vapor coat on top, it'll keep it dry anyway, so I'm not so worried about that. And the orange, if you want, you can turn this inside out very easily, so you can have orange on the outside and black on the inside. And orange is good for visibility in the mountains. If for safety reasons, you've got a big orange sheet here that you can hang out or get attention for in the snow. So from a safety factor, it's good to have a bit of orange with you to get attention. So I'm not going to go into all the benefits of a top quilt, but I'm definitely sold on top quilts now for pack size, weight and performance and versatility. So you can have a look at that on YouTube if you want. So how does it work? Well, let's show you. So first of all, I'll just use it and then I'll show you all the features. So much easier than a sleeping bag. All you need to do, put your feet in the foot box, like that. And then, done. You're in your quilt. Now this is some unique features, so you'll notice the sides aren't wafting up like a normal quilt. There's a reason for that. I designed something in to stop that. And it's hugging my shoulders, so you don't actually need a neck clasp on this one. Although I have put one on, you don't strictly need it because it hugs your shoulders and with elastic and things, so yeah, super comfy. So if you're too hot, you just put an arm out and like a sleeping bag, or you can vent a bit of air in. But yeah, you can see now how lofty it is, very lofty. Now, I'll talk about moving down around. This is unique to this kind of quilt. You can move all the down around to where you need it. You can see the loft is excellent. It's got 2.5 inch baffles, so the highest loft peak could be about 3 inches. So, and what I've done is, there's a thing called Caro step design, but it has a lot of peaks and troughs. The peaks are very high and the troughs are quite low where the little squares are. And this is a chevron type design that I've come up with, that I mathematically have designed it to have the most even loft across the whole sheet, so not many peaks and troughs. You'll see it's quite flat, but it has the maximum loft across the whole lot, so I reckon I've got about 2.75 inches of loft, nearly 3 I would think. So yeah, very good. Right then, some of the features. this one. Start off with the foot box. It's got a draw cord in the bottom. See that? So it cinches up incredibly tight. Now it's been designed in such a way, I don't know if you can see it, but when you're laying down, all the loft is on top and the cinch hole is right at the bottom where your feet are. So what you do is you put your feet in and you put your feet kind of there. That's where your feet go. So the hole ends up being underneath you and therefore there's no air getting in at all. So nice little design there. To save any air getting in through the hole in the foot box or having to stuff it with anything. The next thing is the lacing. So this is a bit different. Normally you have poppers or straps or things like that. I want to eliminate all of that for any failure of those things or for the weight. So what I've done is I just put tiny, tiny tabs into the seam of the quilt. And then between those tabs, all I've done is laced it up exactly like a shoelace. So it goes crisscross, crisscross, crisscross with a loop at the top, and at the bottom, it just goes through a little loop, and then you just tie literally a shoelace at the end, a double knot, which stops it coming undone. So loads of advantages of this. The advantage is you can adjust the width of your foot box. So you can have it as wide or as narrow as you want, depending on how you like to sleep. Another thing is, I'll do it for you. If you pull this, it actually shrinks the foot box, it shortens it. So if you're shorter, not the full length of the quilt, you can shorten this and it has a concertina effect, which giving you even more loft. So if you want to have a shorter quilt, it makes a shortening mechanism there. Also, because it's lacing, can be completely removed, do something else. Or you can have the lacing only on maybe the bottom four, if you just want a tiny foot box and more room at the top, and you can adjust the things you want. So ultimate versatility, ultimate lightness. I've used a very tiny micro cord, 1.8 millimeters. From Dutch Bear Gear. It's a really nice cord, so you can't feel it under you, it's so thin, can't feel it at all. So some more features, I'll do a close up. You can see all the stitching, let's have a look so you can get it in focus. All the stitching is double stitched everywhere. Nice little Z stitching on the tie out, so they're super strong. Exactly what you want. The end channels are just the fabric itself looped over. Now the top half is a bit different again. Normally you'd just have one or two of these tabs and you'd have a strap going from one side to the other, either under your mat or under you, and then you've got something under you which is uncomfy, it can come off, it's just a pain in the neck. So what I've done is I put a right angled tab here, see that? To give sort of a lateral angle, and then I put a very, I think it's 1.5 millimeter, something like that, bungee cord, super tiny bungee cord, from this tab all the way up to the top. So each side I can tension now with a tension. So that gives you a little bit of elastic there that hugs around your body and stops it falling off. So you don't need anything under you. And again, you could tighten that up quite a lot, which would also concertina it and give you more loft on top if you need more warmth or if you're shorter. Also, you can slacken it off and just have a flat sheet. So it's quite adjustable. Now at the top end, what I've done is I've got a micro cord lock with the cord that goes around your neck, but I've also put the thin cord through the same micro lock. So now I can adjust both with one micro lock just by feeling the thickness of the cord. You can do that. So that's a really nice fit. This works really, really well. Hugs it into your body. You can turn over. It doesn't move around, doesn't waft out, so no heat escapes. So I really like that. That works really well. the cord at the top, I'll just slacken this off so it's easier to see. There. So you've got a rolled channel, you've got triple stitch in that side, double stitch in that side. And this is quite a thick cord. This is a 2mm cord going through the top, so it's quite strong. That gives a nice comfortable neck draw. And because of the shock cord on the side and the shock cord in the neck, it gives a little pocket, a little shoulder pocket of elastic. So that hugs over your shoulders, so it doesn't really come off your shoulders. Now if you move around a lot at night and you don't want to trust the elastic to keep it on, I've just put on some little cam snap popper, so you've got a popper around your neck if you want. I want to show you that in detail because there's something on there that's quite useful. There's a popper. Now it's on again with a Z stitching. You'll notice the stitching is black on one side, orange on the other. So it's nicely matching. You've got the stitch in here, which is the main attachment. Then I got another stitch there across, which gives a loop inside there for the micro shock cord to go through, keeps it in place. Then I got the cam snap. This is the double layer. Then I've got another layer of stitch in this side, which gives me a loop on the end. So you can use that for attaching cord to, or hanging it up, or whatever you want to do. So that's quite a lot of stuff all in one snap there. Now you'll notice there's a tab here at the end with nothing on it, so why would I want that? You'll notice also, so you see at the other end, I've also got another tab there which goes round the channel, so still room for the channel. You can remove all the cords, everything. So you've got a hook there, so you've got hooks both ends. So what I'm going to do, you take out the lacing. Here's the lacing for you. Can see that. Take out the lacing, and then you've got one massive sheet with a slight, you've got one big sheet with a slight taper to it. And this is full length, 2.2 meters, so it's a real long quilt. And with these loops, I've got them every 5 inches. That's good enough for the shock cord going down through the body, but also because it's every 5 inches. You can put a thicker shock cord through here, maybe a 3mm shock cord, all the way through to the end, both sides, and hang it underneath a hammock. So you've now got an underquilt. And I'll show you that a bit later. I'll rig that up so you can see what it's like. And these loops on the end are loops so you can add your secondary suspension. So it's a full spec underquilt for a hammock, as well as a top quilt from the ground or in a hammock. So you have your primary suspension going through all these loops up to your webbing, and then this is secondary suspension, so you put cord on here up to your primary webbing, and you can adjust that so the whole thing can move up and down the suspension on under your hammock, and you can adjust it just right. So I'll rig that up for you so you can see what it's like on a hammock. So far so good. It's got loads of loft, no problem for any temperature with this quilt. Because it's so light, it's 700 grams, you can carry it anywhere. It's a lot lighter than a sleeping bag. Don't need zips, don't need Velcro. I try to avoid Velcro on this kind of stuff because it just doesn't do it any good in the long term. Zips are heavy, don't need a zip. Once it's laced up and dialed into how you like it, you can leave it like that and pack it. It's all packable, nothing stiff or anything like that. So yeah, it's just everything you want from a quilt, really. So it's all packed up now. This is the stuff sack. Just put this in a bit tighter. You can compress it down a little bit more, but I wouldn't really want to. But you can see how tiny it is. For a full spec, full winter sleep system, let's see, it'll go smaller in your pack if you want. But yeah, it's just amazing, isn't it? It's perfect. Just a little tiny quilt. So there's loads of great quilts on the market. If you're interested in quilts, Enlightened Equipment make some great ones. Loco Libre in the States make some great ones. So there's just loads of great quilts out there. But this one, It's a bit special, got a lot of features you won't see in any other quilt, so I just thought I'd just go for it and try and make the best quilt I can.
I just wanted to show you a bit more the design. This is the shape of the quilt, square at the top. It's difficult with the type of camera and angle, but square at the top and tapers down to a foot. That saves a bit of weight. This is the chevron design, so I've got baffle there, and there. So there, there. Now the benefit is there's no open channels, the down has to go along, turn a corner round. So Caro steps got open channels down, so down can just flow around a bit easier, but this, it has to navigate round. I think if I made another one, these are 30 centimeters or a foot long, I'd make these a little bit longer and the gaps a little bit smaller just to give a bit more resistance to down, but this works really well. So the benefit is, got too much down at the foot end, you can just brush it, push the down out. Now you've got more down at the base and less down at the foot end. Push it back. Now you've got down even all around. It's a little bit high there. Take it out. Also, when this is around you, you can push the down from underneath while you're in it. So you can actually move down around while you're in it. If you've got too much near your head, you want more to the body, just push it down underneath, get more to your body. You want more to your feet because your feet are cold, just push a bit more underneath to your feet, get warmer. So it's just brilliant. You can just move the down wherever you want. You can see now, every 5 inches I've got a small tab, and that's what I'm going to use to run the suspension from for the when it's in a mode for an underquilt for a hammock. Now it's not the most ideal design for a hammock underquilt because it's not a differential cut, so both sides are the same width. Normally on a hammock underquilt you use a differential cut, so the bit that's near the hammock is less, smaller, and the outside is more, so you can put a lot of weight on it and it won't compress the down, so it's not ideal, but this will make a perfectly serviceable underquilt. You can see the loft there, that's two layers, it's huge. Make a perfectly serviceable underquilt, and I'll set that up next. So, you can... so the underquilt's on, or the top quilt that's now an underquilt is on. You can see it goes along all these little channels with some bungee cord. I'll give you a close up in a minute. The baffles are holding the down in the right places, but you can still move it around if you want a bit more up top or down below. You, but it holds it there, especially with the sticky baffles inside. It's got secondary suspension on the ends. This is a 11 foot gathered end hammock. It's just my prototype one. I just use it for testing all the stuff. Okay, so I'm in the hammock. So you can move it round where your feet are, covering both shoulders. It's got loads. You can move it up and down with the tensioners. And it's lovely. You can feel the warmth already. You don't need it today, it's really hot today, but it's really nice. So just loosen off this a bit. Make it flappy just so you can see. So yeah, you can reach out to the ground, do your cooking or whatever you have to do. You can adjust the tension of this separate to where this is, and you can squash it up or stretch it out depending whether you want more down you can move the down around with your hand. You can feel underneath, I've got at least some places 3 inches of down underneath me. There's no gaps under there. Head end's tight, foot end's tight. So yeah, it makes a really good full length underquilt. But yeah, really pleased with it. Makes a brilliant underquilt. I made a dedicated underquilt with differential cut. It's only 3/4 length, so it is nice and light with baffles, but hangs a little bit better. But this is very good, considering it's a top quilt, really. I'll show you some of the details. So you can see here, I've got very simple, lightweight carabiner. Here's the thin bungee cord, 2mm. And a big fat cord lock, which gives the tension on the lines which go through, see the hoop that I did there on the end, that helps, through all of these little hoops, yeah, all the way down, and that gives it the support it needs. It's not baggy at all. You can concertina it, so those loops I was talking about before here, going up secondary suspension to a toggle that's on both, so you can just adjust it, can't do it one hand, adjust it down, adjust it up, to move the whole quilt up and down, depending on where you need it. You can see it's lovely, there's good shock cord in here, quite strong, so it cuts out any draft in there, and there's quite a lot of down in the end, so that helps. Same at the other end, suspension, secondary suspension, going up to a toggle, and then going up to just clipping on with a little carabiner, different colour, so I know which is the head and foot end, obviously the taper, and then you can do differential, so you can adjust one side more than the other, tighten this side up high where your feet are, and put this one down low where your feet are. And that'll give you a differential hang, so you get more down over your feet on the side that you sleep. Really good. You can see here all the down. It's puffing out really nice. Loads of down underneath you. Loads of down. So there's a pound of down in there. And it just works excellent. I really like it. You just unclip it. Very easy. Okay, let's take you in, see what it's like inside. So just kick my boots off. Everywhere here is wild garlic and bluebells are out. It's really lovely. But everywhere where you stand and crush a wild garlic, you get a really strong smell of wild garlic. So it's just the whole place is just smelling the garlic. I'm just gonna get in the hammock. Okay, so I'm in. Let's have a look. Takes a bit of adjustment, hammocks. There we go. So you can see I'm in the hammock. I've got loads of down around my shoulder, which is not getting compressed, so that's good. I move some down, more down. Don't need it around my head. So just move it down around the shoulder, you've got more there. Reach over the other side, yeah, loads there. You can see I've got a straight lay, absolutely flat. And then at this end, you can just pull this up a little bit more, so you've got more down around your feet, and less on this side, because there's nothing there. So yeah. Best place to be. Don't believe me? That's Shug. So you can just pop out, do your stuff, just have a little feel underneath. Make sure it's not touching the floor because that'll soak up moisture. So I'll probably have this a little bit higher. But if you can look, this is the most stretched bit and there's still a good 3 inches there under my arse. So yeah, it's perfect. I don't think you get any cold spots. It needs a bit of a test out in some cold weather. It's going to be a little while now, but it's just lovely. I'd probably tighten these up a little bit more just to keep it up a little bit, but yeah, it's perfect. Yeah, absolutely perfect. So there you go. I'm going to stay here for a little while now, have a kip. So that's your top quilt and an under quilt, all in one. Call it multi-quilt maybe, I haven't got a name for it at all. But yeah, it's really good, I really like it. So this will be my replacement now for all my trips. Might take a 3/4 one and use this as a top quilt maybe, but we'll see. But yeah, really good. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, enjoyed the quilt, and have a bit more look at quilts that are on the market maybe, for your own use. Okay, cheers, bye.